We thank the Lord for giving you the eagerness to hear and learn the Bible lessons daily. These programs are sent every day to help those who do not get the time to read the Bible systematically, as well as those who have already read the Bible several times yet desire to get reminded about the teachings of the Bible in a clear and deep way in English and Tamil languages. These programs are being sent in both audio and script formats every day to help us grow in the knowledge of God. Kindly continue to listen, read, and be benefited by these lessons daily. However, these programs should in no way be used to replace the Bible. These are being sent mainly to encourage and motivate you to read and to study your own Bibles regularly. God bless you all.
Learn the Bible series, program number 129, Bible Depths Notes, part 10, portion 1, pages 1, 2 and 3. The book of 2 John verse 4, John tells the elect lady to whom he writes this letter that he was rejoicing greatly to know that the people in her church were walking in truth. What did he mean by it? Walking in truth was the same as loving one another. He says that they had also been doing it from the beginning. Verse 5. There is a true story about a missionary who walked in truth and showed his love on another person in action. A missionary by name Nichols came from the United States and was ministering in India about 80 years back. After a few years of ministry, he was struck with tuberculosis. There were not much of medical facilities in India at that time to treat that disease. So he argued with God, saying, "Lord, how can I be a witness for you and do ministry for you with this disease in me? So I shall go back to my country itself." But God told him to read Luke 9:62, which said, "Any man who turned back while doing God's ministry would not be fit for the kingdom of God." So Nichols became quiet and said, "Lord, use me even in the midst of my disease." His disease went from bad to worse and he was admitted in a sanatorium. Therefore, he gave the gospel pamphlets and began telling the other patients in the sanatorium about Jesus. But they all made fun of him, saying, "Your God is unable to heal you yourself. So why do you tell us about such a God?" One night, a patient in his ward had to go to the restroom. There were no male nurses close by. That patient could not rise up by himself. So he dirtied his bed and the entire ward was filled with a bad smell. After some time, when the male nurses came to the ward, they came to know about this matter and immediately they started shouting at the patient. One of them gave him one or two blows also, because they only had to clean his bed. All the other patients in the ward were sad that one day or other they may also face the same fate. The next night came. The same patient had to go to the toilet once again. But in spite of several attempts to rise up from the bed, he could not do it. So he began to cry loudly. Missionary Nichols was watching him throughout. He got up from his bed and, though he himself was very weak, lifted up that patient from the bed, placed him on his shoulders and left him near the restroom. He waited outside till he came out of the toilet, carried him back again on his shoulders and laid him in his bed. All the patients in the ward were watching all that Nichols was doing. Another patient in the ward went near the bed of Nichols, gave him a cup of hot tea and asked him to give a gospel pamphlet. The same night, that patient repented and accepted Lord Jesus as his Savior. Nichols rejoiced over that man's salvation and thanked God for using him to win his first soul for the Lord in spite of his own inabilities. Next day, Nichols died, but went peacefully to the Lord, thanking him for giving him an opportunity to walk in truth and to show his love on another person. Likewise, John says that every believer must also walk in truth, showing his love on others. 2 John verse 10. Why is John asking people not to accept some preachers into their houses? Only the scribes, Pharisees and Sadducees were teaching the Old Testament to the Jewish masses those days. But after the ministry of Lord Jesus in this world, some people in the early church began to explain the teachings of Lord Jesus in more detail by visiting the believers' houses. As the believers could learn many more things about the Lord through the explanation of these preachers for the first time in their lives, they gave a great honor to them, giving them a royal reception in their houses. Some rich believers asked them to stay in their houses, gave them a rich food and offerings also. So making use of this opportunity, some unsaved rogues also pretended as though they too were preachers and began visiting the believers' houses and babbling some false doctrines. Therefore, to save the early church from such false preachers only, John gave this advice to the believers of those days. God willing, we shall continue this lesson in our next program. God bless you all.